beaten Hoppers Crossing to the just two.
As we get ready now for the start of the third quarter, umpire raises the ball over to our commentary team, Peppy, Tomsey and Willow. Have a great quarter, guys.
We're underway to start the third quarter. Armstrong Weston got the tap and the Warriors go forward. Chasing after it is Jago. Had a sprightly second half of the second quarter. Gets the hand pass over the top. Running pass beautifully was Barbieri. He was mown down though as he ran into goal. Jago follows up, throws it onto the boot, and it's over the boundary line on the full. It promised so much, that passage of play, but delivered little for them, and now the Vikings can clear. And taking a mark there is
Jarwood. Is playing with one
Jarwood,
hand.
Jarwood, he really is.
He's got two fingers tightly strapped. The early mark.
He literally took that with one hand. He's got only one finger on that left hand is working.
Pretty heavily strapped, isn't it?
It is. So that was an awkward marking attempt. He got the job done, though, but the kick wasn't great. The Warriors can poke it forward.
Too easy.
Barbieri just fills a hole there. About 60 from goal still. Don't know if he's got the legs. He's going to set it up. It's a good-looking kick, though. It might have the distance, but sitting on the goal line and taking an easy mark.
That'll pay.
And trying to soccer it through is Al Houli, and it's going to be touched.
What was that?
I don't know.
What happened then?
Well, first of all, I can't believe he was alone on the goal line there.
He could have let it go.
Within 10 metres of him, but yeah, he probably should have let it go.
Yeah.
Behind to start.
That was different.
Little fumble there. But the Vikings can work it out. And again, Jarwood has the footy.
Not bad to take two marks with one arm, with one hand. By Jarwood. Jarwood now goes, centres the ball. He's got post there, takes the easy uncontested mark at half forward, now goes over the top. Oh, Barbieri smothers it as he's looking for Spiteri, who follows it up now. Spiteri, play on, I think the advantage was paid there. Now it's gone to Andrews, who goes looking inside 50. Abdoum Zayed is running over the top, and the ball's coming out now for the Warriors. With Fletcher now, he clears halfback, has a bounce. Handball's into Smith. He gets it back to Fletcher, the old 1-2 there. As Fletcher goes long down the line towards Poland, and the ball beats him out of bounds. Good use of the ball there by the Hoppers Crossing team there to clear the ball out there.
I can't believe Post kicking, smothered off the boot, just slow from hand to foot sometimes, young Jaden Post. But good to see Spiteri further up the ground too, Eltona. They made a couple of moves at half-time, get him up into the game through that midfield.
So the throw in, it's just inside 50, and it's Armstrong Weston who snaps it about 50, pushes it to the right, and it's through for one behind. So 3 minutes gone, Hoppers Crossing 11, 10, 76, Eltona 2, 3, 15.
Peppy's just discovered what a hat's really for.
Doesn't work now, the binoculars don't fit.
That sun is very hard in your eyes, boys.
Mitch Palmer followed up and now poking a kick inside 50. And with the footy in hand is Poland. He marks about 45 from goal. He's going to have to kick it every bit of 50 metres, though, but you'd think he'd be within range with the assistance of a bit of breeze. 11-9 plays 2-3 as Poland comes in. Looking for goal number 3. Hoists it up. The wind looks to drift it back.
Well done,
perfectly orchestrated from Adam Poland. He kicks his third, and it's now 12-9-81 to 2-3-15. 3.5 gone of the third.
Very exciting young player is Adam Poland. He done that. That kick a goal then was under no pressure. It's probably only his third season of senior football, open age football, but he's just slotted himself into this line up across that half forward line through the midfield excellently for the Hoppers Crossing team. And that kick was just nice and easy, nice and steady, no panic, put it right through for his third. So well done.
66 points the margin. 4 minutes gone, third quarter. Ball back in the middle. Umpire throws it up. Armstrong Weston with the hit out. But he hits it down to his Vikings opponent, and it's scrambled forward there by Cavallaro. Just hacks it to half forward. No one's able to gather clean possession here. Ball comes out to Watt now. It just hacks one forward. And it hits Al Houli on the chest, but it bounces off his chest as Cameron Zulo gathers. Gets a handball out to Andrews. And now finds his teammate in Turnbull. Handball in middle. Andrews kept running. Now it's with Pickard, who had to turn around and chip it out wide. And another one-handed mark out there to Jarwood. He's doing very well. Good effort by him. So Jarwood runs off, plays on off the mark, kicks it inside 50, looking for a mark. No one's able to take it. Ball spills to the ground. Could be in the back here, but it's not paid. And the pack gathers and we'll have a ball up probably about 40 metres out from the Altona goal.
That's compared to the first quarter, even 5 minutes into this third quarter, going against the wind here, Altona, a little bit better. They just controlled, kept possession of the football there. A couple of handballs, just kept moving the ball forward. That's what they've got to do for the remainder. They'll get goals, it's proven. It's not that strong a breeze. They can get goals against the wind here, going up to the one tree end of the ground, if they can get the ball on the move and get it forward.
Rafferty tapped it goal side. Now the Warriors. Oh, the kick out of the pack, though, for Altona towards goal. Just misses near side. And one behind. 2-4-16 to 12-9-81. Kick goes out to the right half back flank. Tracking it to the boundary line was Ryan. And they work it around beautifully here. Ryan there just hanging back, finds some space. And now running down the outer side, the Warriors. Beautiful kick looking for Meade. Oh, he take the mark. He was 50? Brought to ground heavily. 50. No 50 paid. It was a strong mark, and Meade is slow to get up.
Oh, geez. That's what I thought they brought the 50-metre rule in for things like that. He was really driven into the ground hard there, Geordie Meade. What a beautiful passage of play, too, from Reece Miles. He's really hitting his straps over the last couple of weeks. Apparently, he's their best player last week, and again, that was exciting.
Barbieri just strolls into a hole a little about 20 metres closer, and Meade honours the lead. And the mark is taken, and Meade Barbieri now, who kicked a... No, he didn't. But he's going to go back now.
So once again, why should Barbieri get that? He's just ran into a little hole, a little gap that wasn't covered by Altona defence there.
Pokes the kick, just drifts left, and it's going to be a behind. 12-10-82 to 2-4-16.
It's like Altona, it's like they spend 2 or 3 seconds, you know, which is a long time, just switching off. Lack of concentration, they just drop right off and then allow Hoppers Crossing off the ball to run into space or to create a better position.
Kicking, flying over the top for what Hoppers Crossing couldn't take the mark, and now out the back. Hand pass, Jarward literally trying to hang onto it with one hand. He's just pushed over the boundary line by Palmer. He is literally playing with one hand out there.
Jarward. He's taking 3 marks as well.
He has. Up they go. Armstrong Weston just reaches in front, gets the hand pass across. Barbieri was there. Released Turner. Kick to the top of the goal square, flying in front there. Great fist. Defensive spoil across the front of the pack by Turnbull. Sees it through for a rush behind. Margin 67. Out the back now, Magna Bosco. Found his teammate in Sanyi. Pokes one out wide. Meade.
Great pressure.
Great tackle on his opponent. Hand pass was released though. Kitchen's in there trying to get a touch, but it's over the boundary line. Far side of the ground. 8.5 gone of the third. 67 points, the Warriors lead.
Geordie Meade doesn't get the pats on the back for the hard work that he does off the football. He, you know, he's ran 40 metres there just to create pressure and then lay a tackle. His defensive part of the game is as good as any small forward going around.
Fletcher did well to Turner, and now the kick forward. Bentley almost had it. And now a pack forms inside the forward 50. Gee, it got down there quickly. And about 30 out now. The umpire will call for it.
Ball up now. Ball clears, comes out to Magna Bosco for the Vikings, and he sees it over the boundary line just in front of the scoreboard here. So the scoreboard reads 9 minutes gone. Hoppers Crossing 12-11-83, Altona 2-4-16. Big lead here for Hoppers Crossing. The throw in now. The hit out there by Bentley. The ball is a big pack forming. There's a whistle. It's going to be a free kick. It's going the Warriors' way. It's going to Bentley. Head over the ball. He's earned the free kick there.
Yeah, well done, young Aussie Bentley. Once again, as I mentioned earlier, on really coming of age as a footballer, this young fella.
So Bentley gets the free kick. He's going to kick from about 35 metres out, 45-degree angle on the outer side here at Hogan's Road Reserve. Kicking to the Hogan's Road end. So in comes Bentley on his way. Kick.
Beautiful.
The umpire does not move at all. He's put it straight through the middle. Great goal there. That was his first for Joel Bentley for the afternoon. So that's 13-11-89. Altona 2-4-16. 10 minutes gone, third quarter.
Nine different goal kickers for Hoppers Crossing. Just shows that spread. As you mentioned, Bentley's first one, first goal. But, you know, the rotation where he's come, himself and Armstrong Weston have worked in the ruck, pushing forward on different occasions. It's working a treat at the moment. Coming back to the centre.
Up they go again. Armstrong Weston decisively down to Ryan. And now Turner with a little kick forward. Just evaded Poland. And now able to clear it out. There is Gertz. A kick towards left half forward. Just got a little bit of an awkward bounce. Still scrambling for it at left half forward. Now the hand pass forward. Strong punch there. Defending well, and the umpire is going to come and ball this up. Left half forward to the end. Altona is attacking. They trail by 73 points. 11 going to the final of the third quarter. Sorry. Up we go. Barbieri at the back, trying to sling it forward, and now just a string of hand passes, and again they find space. Following up is Barbieri, but it's over the boundary line. Closer now to the far wing. Toss back into play. No one went up for it. Altona, little scrimmage forward. Following up is Joe Ward. And now releasing Lunardi, and a beautiful pass. Nice. Lace out inside the 50. Not much Ferrari could do there. And from about 35 metres out, just to the right of centre post, will go back. And he'll need to show a little bit more care with this one than he did an attempt earlier in the second quarter.
Nice kick from Lunardi there. Good lead from Jaden Post. Just starting to get himself into the game at the moment. Coming off interrupted pre-season.
And that one's not going to trouble the scorers, but flying across the front and taking a strong mark near the goal line.
Shields, maybe?
Perhaps.
Looks like Turnbull, I'd say. Not. No. Going to get another kick anyway, whoever it is. 55. Who's that? 55? Pickard.
Pickard.
And Kelly Pickard. So, umpire's called it back.
Pickard from the left forward pocket. He marked it just a few metres from the goalpost, so he'll have an acute angle to deal with. And the wind blowing hard off his left side. And he kicked the Vikings third.
Well done.
He does. Beautiful kick from Pickard. He's got two now. And it's 3-4-22 Altona. They trail Hoppers Crossing 13-11-89 after 13 minutes.
Yeah, a little bit better by Altona there. Well done to Pickard. As I say, the kick from Post once again just veering off to the left, but a good grab by Pickard. Look, the steam's gone right out of this game at the moment, no doubt. Just what Altona can grab out of this, they need to just keep pushing away. They don't want to see a 10-goal loss, bottom line of it is. They need to just get, they are going to go down. It needs to be, you know, under the 10-goal, under the 8-goal even, from what they've started. Nothing's gone right from today so far. Geordie Robbins, Billy Ward, both off the ground for the rest of the game, early in the piece of this game. So they're down, down on rotations to start with.
The umpire throws it up and it spills out wide. Now here come the Warriors again. Now it's with Miles, who's on half forward, kicks it into Bentley, gives the handball back to Miles now from about 60, passes inside looking for Meade, gets it on the bounce, spins out of trouble, now goes back with a bit of a right foot banana, and it's going to fall in Kitchen's hands. It did, but he couldn't take the mark, and the ball hits the left hand point post. It will have a throw in the left forward pocket for the Hoppers Crossing as they lead by 67 points, 14 minutes gone, third quarter.
He's gone right out of the game a bit. Ryan Kitchen from early piece.
He has a throw-in now. His ball kick is smothered, and three Altona players dive in to make the tackle and will have a ball up.
G.L. Hawley's hard at it.
Yeah, and good, strong body work from him. Tackles, but his body work is sensational.
A toss-up now. hit out now. It comes to Abu Zayed, gets the handball out to Andrews, goes back to Zanya, gets across goal. Dangerous kick here, needs a mark for the Vikings, but it's unable to take it. Now it's picked up by Wood, who's pinned, he's tackled, he gets the handball out to Al Hawley, but he's been pinged for holding the ball, and it'll be a free kick in the left back pocket for the Vikings. They go to the switch now. Look at it, Abu Zayed, he takes the mark. Plays on, now goes inboard, finds Lenardi, who marks it right half back. Slow option, now a little short chip one, just outside 50 back to Abu Zayed. They're not moving the ball quickly, but at least they're holding on to it in this quarter. Not like the first quarter where they got smashed going into the wind. Abu Zayed goes long down the line. Oh, big fly there by Pickard. Gets the handball off quickly. Goes to Zawad. Jawad, kicks looking for post. He almost takes the two grab, unable to. Ball now spilling inside the forward 50 for the Vikings. It's picked up by Bentley. Handballs, misses the target in Smith, but he's able to gather. And he handballs back. Oh, high tackle there. Not paid. Oh, unlucky there, the Hoppers crossing player. And the ball spills now left forward pocket. And for the Altona Vikings, they kick towards the One Tree Hill end.
One Tree Hill.
That's what we call it.
Ferrari was under the pump there, so it's thrown back into play. Reaching across was Pickard. Can he find something out of nowhere? He kicked towards goal, but in front, Hoppers crossing, able to clear it. And now with acres of space, stepping around his opponent and releasing Chrysostomo. Beautiful kick inside the 50, inside the forward 50 now from Miles of Mead. He was collected late again.
Another 50? Not paid? Wow.
Sensational football.
That was again a bit late, and Bridie's got something to say about that. They're not quite happy with the treatment Mead's been getting.
Yeah, rightly so. Rightly so. Great defence work too. Bit of the ear tickling.
Yeah.
The old whack behind the ear as he went, mate, he earned it. He's a tough character, Mead. He's up. He loves it. He thrives on it. But good. At least Altona having a bit of a crack.
Mead now right in front. He'll kick from about 45. Strolls in. It's a good-looking kick. It has done the job. Jordan Mead with his third of the afternoon. 14-11-95 now. The Warriors 3-4-22 Altona. So the margin's back out to that 73-point margin.
Yeah, look, it's that delivery, that run. Reece Miles has really come into the game since about quarter time. He's run and carry, which he's so well known for, a premiership player at Altona, you know, 5 or 6 years ago. He's doing that run and carry of the football. And that delivery into Mead on a good, strong 30-metre lead was sensational. And the Altona player just had nothing to do, nothing he could do there, but, as I say, just try and contest and drive him into the ground.
Miles almost stormed away from the clearance, but the Vikings are able to steal it, and now it goes to Russo, who pumps it looking. Well, he's got a free kick out there. I think it's going to Miles. Or so Shields for, that was right, so Davis. Third, three out of four times I get it right. So Davis with the free kick for the Vikings. Now it goes inside. There's no Vikings player able to take the mark. The ball spills out wide now. I think the Vikings is going to have a ball out now, probably about 40 metres out from goal, as towards the Vikings end of the ground. And umpires called time on.
I don't know, they're right. All good.
Now it's going to be a free kick. Out of this, going to Davis. Don't know what that's for. So Davis kicks now from about 50 metres. He's just setting it up, looking for a marking, targeting post.
Beautiful.
He's taking it uncontested.
Clean
good
run
kick.
At it.
Yeah. Good play there by the Vikings. Jaden Post will come in for his first goal of the afternoon, kicking from about 25 metres out with no angle to speak of.
And that's what they need to do. They need Post to be on the move. It's not just going to be a pack mark, standing pack mark.
Post comes in, makes the umpire work a little bit. But I think he's got it. He has.
Well done.
So the goal there to the Vikings, their fourth of the afternoon. But they trail Hoppers crossing 14-11-95 to 4-4-28. That lead now 67 points. 19 and a half gone, third quarter.
Yeah, he needs to be on the move. The ball needs to be put out in front of him, Post, 20 metres out. Make him work to the football. if you kick the ball long and high, Jane Post, it's still not, he's not strong enough in the body to be able to take the big pack marks. He needs to get a run and leap at it. And that situation there, you know, that 15 metres in front of him, he had to make ground to get there. And that's was a good result in the end.
Back in the middle, 88.9. Win FM and 90.1 if you're at the ground. Rafferty got a big hit down, but it came the way of Smith, who was just loitering at the back of the goal square, centre circles, inside 50. Kitchen was there, but now able to clear it out. And now weaving their way through beautifully, Zanyi with the footy. That's a poor kick, that's out on the full. And they worked it well there, Altona, but just, again, poor execution coming out of their defensive 50. And with the footy now, Matt Ryan, the captain, still with plenty of the ball. Perfect kick for Bentley in the middle of the ground. Just pokes one, maybe didn't quite catch it as he would have liked. Running past and finding possession was Watt. Can he wheel onto his right boot? That's a beauty.
Nice one.
Murphy Watt, heard to you. Good work.
And they just managed to find space yet again, and Murphy Watt the beneficiary this time. 15-11, 101 to 4-4-28, and Altona, whenever they can find a goal, Hoppers Crossing seemingly respond instantly.
Yeah, look, Murphy Watt, the Hoppers Crossing boy, went up to Melton for a couple of years, the last couple of years in the Ballarat League, as a more of a run-with match-up type of player. Come back to Hoppers this year, and I don't think he's got that role anymore because he finished that off so well. I think he's got a bit more of a license to work through that midfield. So good luck and well done to him.
Ball back in the middle. Ryan's going to do the roving here. Spins out of trouble. Well done by the captain. Handball's out wide to Palmer, who now pumps it forward. Clears Kitchen now, but it's a bit of a running race. Poland unable to gather. Fumbled it twice, actually. Handball's now. Good recovery there by Poland. Good run by Ryan, who came in to help out. And he centres the ball. Finds Bentley in centre wing. He kicks it into his teammate, Galley, in the back of the head. It's hitting Lenardi now, gathers. For the Vikings, handballs it over to Manavong, I think it is. Kicks long to the top of the goal square. The mark is dropped there by Post. And the players dive in now. We'll have a ball up right next to the left point post at the Vikings end of the ground.
Bit of set up by Altona there. Some good run, good carry.
Bit of luck there.
Beneficiary of a Falcon.
Yeah. Bentley kicking into his mate's teammate's head as quickly off the...
Was that a...
I don't know.
No, it's a free kick out there.
Free kick has been paid, yeah, you're
don't
right.
Don't know what for.
Free kick to Altona. Might be Davies, I'd say. Came off three goals last week.
Yeah, it is Davies. Davis.
Davis, sorry.
So Davis coming in from about 10 metres out. Yeah, he's put it through for the Vikings' fifth, so... Davis gets his first, Altona's fifth, so the score now 15-11, 101 to 5-4, 34, 67-point lead again for the Warriors.
Yeah, didn't pick up as well, boys, what the free kick was for, but nevertheless, finished off by Davis. As I said, three goals last week, got his one today so far, but that's a good effort. They've just got to keep plugging away, as I mentioned earlier on. They really do not need to go down by a 10-goal margin, Altona. Very important to just keep working hard the remainder of this third quarter and come home hopefully strongly, outscore Hoppers in the last. Grab something out of this.
Armstrong Weston got the tap for the Warriors. Out wide, great tackle by Turner on his opponent. Just kept the ball in there. Umpire will come in and do it again. Just laterally from the centre circles. 23 and a half minutes gone. Margin is 67. As they go at it again. Clever little tap down. Came the way, though, of Altona. The kick didn't have too much on it. And now they dive in again. This time in the muddy patch in the middle of the ground. Armstrong Weston, again, strong with his hands, just kind of guided it down. Poland ended up with it. Shrugged the tackle, now got the hand pass away. Thumping kick towards goal. It might have the carry. It's drifting right. And a minor score. 15-12, 102 to 5-4-34. 68 points the margin. A couple of short passes out of defence and it ends up with Pickard now. two kicks from his defensive 50. He's going to go back. Ooh, it's a questionable kick. Meade was closing in, but able to take the mark was Magna Bosco. He's just camped there in his defensive goal square. Didn't have enough on it for Kamenzuli. His kick
again,
just
Meade.
Had to throw it on the boot and get it out of there. Not too badly. Jawad again, one-handed.
Threw that one.
Manivong diving in. He's tackled. Barbieri, one of them. And Ricky Wood, the other. Throw up. Well done there. And Jawad just, again, he is really cradling that left hand.
Yeah, he's really struggling with it. It's hard. He is only playing with one hand and very heavily taped. Broken finger, whatever it may be, on his left hand there. So he's struggling with it.
He's only got his pinky and his wedding ring finger, if he's got one in in use. As it comes out the back to Watt, he pumps it forward. Meade's there. Oh, but at the back. Strong mark, Al Hooley. Just camped under the footy and fell in his lap. And from about 15 metres from goal, he should be able to kick his second.
Once again, out the back of the pack there. Hoppers crossing and they're away.
Al Hooley kicks through it. And it's a goal. Two goals for him. And he's been very good today, Al Hooley. 16-12, 108 to 5-4, 34, and it's a seesawing final term.
Yeah, just at the back of that contest again, Hoppers crossing time and time again. The boundary throw-ins, they've had two or three just loitering around that midfield area. And as soon as they've got it, they've had the loose numbers to peel it out and push it forward. So Altona just haven't been able to counter that at all throughout the day.
74 points to the margin. So close to three-quarter time here. Umpire throws it back up in the middle. Sean Weston clearly with the tap out. It's into space. But it's only running on, only benefit. Oh, now the ball spills out. I think Turner with it kicks it long inside 50. It's got a bit of a foot race now with Al Hooley, and Meade's there as well. Good use of the body by Al Hooley. Meade comes in and gives away the free kick. Yep, free kick against Meade's going to Kamenzuli at right half back for the Vikings. So Kamenzuli is long down the line, looking for a marking target. That's the only. Mark's not paid by Palmer. The ball is touched.
Yep.
So we have a ball up right in front of the social club here at Hoppers Crossing. 27 and a half minutes gone, third quarter. Ball's up now. Picard sort of won the hit out. Armstrong Weston with the second tap, and the ball's now spilled out of bounds right in front of the broadcast caravan here.
They're going to go at it again here. Armstrong Weston wrestles his way to the front. Picard got first hands to it, and it goes straight back over the line.
Just watch this throwing again. It's so many times I've mentioned it. It is right in front of the caravan at the Hogan's Road end pocket. Our easy hoppers can get out the back here.
At the back. Oh, Picard was just slung to the ground, and he will receive the free kick.
Yeah, against Armstrong Weston there.
Rafferty just having a little bit of a word with Armstrong Weston there. And the kick, wow, that wasn't the best example of what a drop punch should look like, but it found Jawad regardless. Just back of the wing.
Nothing to kick to, looking up the ground here. So just kick it up the line, which that's the last thing they need.
Good looking kick, but oh, trying to take the mark there, but now at the back, Shields got the kick forward, chasing after it. There is Russo. Gathers, tries to keep it in play, but he wasn't able to. It's out of play. Right half forward for the Vikings. They trail by 74. 29 minutes gone. We shouldn't be far away from three-quarter time. Throw in again. At the back, trying to squeeze a kick towards goal with Spiteri. And now running in is Russo. And he's just slung it across the face of the goal.
Wow.
I think he should have done better than that. The Warriors will claim it from the right half, but right back pocket.
Joshy Russo not having a very good afternoon at all. Smart little kick by Lee Spiteri there, just off his the outside of his right boot, just sent Russo out wider, just instead of handballing, it's only gone just on the 15 metres, but just got it out to him.
Shields mans the mark. The kick was poor. It's going to come straight back inside 50. Short pass. Lunardi takes the mark, and now he's got Joe Ward running shotgun at centre half 40. Takes the mark, but the Warriors close the gap. He's not able to run on with it. Not too many options. Might have to go the long ball. He pokes one into the forward pocket. Up they fly. It was not a bad kick. Spiteri was underneath it. He couldn't quite take the mark, and now the Warriors can clear it out the right side, but that was a poor kick, and Pickard, I believe, has taken the mark.
He's been good today for Altona. Pickard, he's had a go right from the start. Kicked a couple of goals, but really put his body on the line. They've got him in the ruck.
He's thrown his weight around a bit too. One of the only players this afternoon for the Vikings have done it.
And that'll do it for the third term. Set 5 goals still to Hoppers Crossing, but Altona were a little better there. They kicked 3 of their own. 16-12, 108 to 5-4. 34, the final change.
Well, it's been a little bit better quarter, third quarter there from Altona, putting a couple on the board, but the pressure from Hoppers Crossing just relentless there, so extending their margin again here at three-quarter time. Tomsey, you saw the third quarter. Are there any positives at all?
The Altona player just having a shot from 85 metres out after the siren there. Didn't make the distance. No real positives at all there, Troy, for Altona in that quarter.
Fantastic, and we'll be back with more of the action. Right now, we'll just head off to a break. Fourth and final quarter, where Altona are getting dominated here by Hoppers Crossing, 108 to 34. Start of the last quarter, over to our commentary team. Good call, guys.
88.9 Win FM, back in the middle. Kick forward from Matt Smith for the Warriors. Mopped up, though, out the back, and now the kick goes straight back over their heads to centre half forward for the Vikings. Underneath it was Cavallaro, couldn't take the mark, and now the pack forms. So it's a 74-point lead to Hoppers Crossing. Flying third man up there for the Vikings, and now the kick goes towards full forward. Outnumbered, unable to take the mark, though, was Murphy Watt. But still, Ferrari got the kick out wide to left half back. Handball keeps it into play. Arnott, Al Hawley back to Arnott. Couple of little hand passes. And as I asked in the three-quarter time break, that cloud has drifted across, and a little reprieve from the sunshine.
We can see.
You're very happy about that. Jared Arnott tries to step around an opponent. And now, here he is again, Armstrong Weston with a bit of pace that we saw earlier, doing it again. And now Miles weaving his way through. Palmer takes a bounce, hand pass across. Miles again, I think. Or it was Smith. Still, though, working at Ford Kitchen, trying to find some space. Smith was there again, running all the way from halfback, and the kick towards full forward, but floating in front. Unable to take the mark, though, were the defenders for Altona. Andrews mopping up, and now they're able to find some space. Jaward offers something on the centre wing, doesn't go to him, but now releasing centre wing, streaming through there was Turnbull. He took 3 bounces before delivering to centre half forward. Cavallaro got front and centre, hacked it towards full forward. It's all about the bounce now, and it went sideways. It was an off break, and it's through from behind. The first score of the final term. After 2 minutes, 5-5-35, 16-12, 108.
Should grab them posts. You know, he tried to make that on the chest. In the end, that should have been hands out. Grab that. Look, Mitchie Turnbull, great setup. He's been their best player today. Altona, he's really worked hard across the half-back line. Spent different times in the midfield. Run a carry there from him was very good.
So throw in, left half forward for the Vikings. Picard with the hit out. No clear kick there. Now it's hacked forward by the Vikings inside 50, great but mark. A good one out of mark.
Fletcher.
Taken by Fletcher.
It was a nice mark. Benny Fletcher.
He's at right half back for the Warriors. And Fletcher is long down the line, clearing kick. Looking for a marking target. No one gets a hand on it. Ball spills to Rafferty. Gives hands handball, and then gets back to Rafi now on his left foot, goes back to basically where Fletcher kicked it from. The ball trickles inside 50, and now it's seen out of bounds, about 45 metres out from the Vikings' goals. They trail by 73 points, 3 minutes gone, final quarter.
Pickard still in the ruck here for Altona.
It was a half contest from the throw-in. Cavallaro was in there. He was tackled by Fletcher and will have a bounce.
Armstrong Weston, still Foppers crossing. He's gone all day. He's had a bit of a break, Armstrong Weston, in the ruck from young Aussie Bentley, but he's done most of the ruck work himself.
Armstrong Weston reached over, got the tap, and now out the back, Palmer. Went to give the hand pass off, but decided to go himself. Now he weaves one across the ground. Matt Ryan, the captain, kicks towards left half forward. Kitchen was there. In fact, it was Mead. Apologies. And now Jago. A little bit of work. Tries to get it back off his teammate. Didn't work out for them. Little hand pass back. Mead shrugs the tackle. Now pokes one short. Wasn't 15. Umpire calls play on. Kick to the top of the goal square. And wrestling there. And taking a strong mark in the
kick.
Goal square.
Free is it going to be a free? Yeah,
hands in the back.
Yep. Oh, you're probably right, it was there. Short kick, gee, that was poor. And it might turn out to be a goal anyway. Comes the way of Bentley. Can he steer one home? Yes!
Well done.
Great finish from Joel Bentley. Brilliant stuff, and I believe that is his first goal. Their 11th. No, his second. Still, they've got 10 goal scorers for the day. It's 17-12, 114 to 5-5-35.
The free kick, obviously there for Altona, but the turnover, easy, soft turnover again, and they just pounce. They had numbers around the contest there, Hoppers Crossing, and it's a matter of who wanted to kick the goal in the end. And Joel Bentley in the right position, put through for his second goal. They haven't helped their cause today, Altona, with some simple fundamental mistakes whenever the ball in their hands.
Ball back in the middle, Picard gets the hit out. For Lenardi, he's unable to take it. It's Barbieri, gets it, handballs in the middle to Palmer, gives it to Smith, who has a bounce in the middle of Hogan's Road Reserve. Now hacks one for a bit of a torp. Perfect. Inside 50. It came off beautifully though, as Ryan Kitchen takes the mark on his chest about 25 metres out on a 45 degree angle.
Yeah, just well read in the air there by Ryan Kitchen. He seen it was a little bit skew if off the boot, and he got that the front position of the side, and that's where the ball went. So a good finish to him.
So Kitchen's got one this afternoon. Comes in, looking to put Hoppers Cross, his 18th on the board. He kicks on its way. I think he's got it. He has. 2 to Ryan Kitchen, 18 to the Warriors as they lead by 85 points. 18-12, 120 to 5-5-35.
That's what they don't need, Altona. That wind has dropped down completely now. They're coming home with a 1-3 end. The Hoppers boys, and as we mentioned, the last thing that Altona want is to go down by over 10 goals, and at the moment it looks like it's going to be over 15 goals.
That's 100 points, isn't it?
Yeah, they've really put up the white flag at the moment. A lot of the Altona players, very average body language on them. Sadi Gazi, their senior coach, the match committee should be pretty disappointed in this showing today.
Up they go. Picard got the tap down. Hand pass comes out wide. Russo sweeps a hand pass across, and now it ends up with Rafferty. Gives one out wide again, and now the kick comes forward. It was well worked. Shields plays on, heard the voice, and now kick towards full forward. Beautifully done.
No free kick.
Made the free. Hands in the back.
No, another post. One. I'm not even noticing them. That's two in a row.
Yeah, he just leaned back at the right time there. Ferrari just in the post, in the hands from post, and got the free kick.
Alex Chrysostomo did well. Worked his way through traffic, got the kick forward. Poland got the hand pass out the back. Wood gathered, and now, wow, a searing ball. Wow, that never went a couple of metres off the ground. Perfect for Matt Ryan, who hung onto it in the centre of the ground. Pokes one forward. Smith. And he's another who's had plenty of the football. Just drifts one out wide. Armstrong Weston thumps one towards the left forward flank, and Mead, easy as you like, uncontested mark over there. And now pokes one inside, and Bentley takes the mark. Still just outside the 50. But with a reprieve from the wind, he might have enough. Instead, he decides to give it off. And the kick inside 50, and it's just very little pressure on inside there. Jago just pokes one inside again, but that was poor.
It was poor.
Russo came across the front of the pack and took the mark. Out wide now for Altona. Finding some space, probably got let off the hook there. Lunardi, short pass inboard. Found Magna Bosco, got the hand pass away. Now the kick inside 50, floating across with courage in front of the pack was Al Hawley. He took a strong mark and then went on with it. Kicked out towards, looking for Ryan. Did well, got around Manavong. Now got the hand pass back from his teammate and poked one towards half forward. Was a high up and under. Wasn't his best effort, not direct. And now the Vikings can work it towards centre half forward with a searing ball. That's well done. Taking a mark and going on with it. Spiteri ducks around, but he ran into the tackle. Did well enough. Umpire called advantage towards full forward. And another untimely bounce.
He's going to bring it back?
No. He's called play on.
It was advantage was paid. And behind to Spiteri.
This has petered out to have all the intensity of a January training run.
Yeah, it has. Yeah, very dull. Very dull and boring second half. We'll get through there, though, guys. We'll get through there. The sun's gone. Pepe's happy. That's the main thing. We can see the game at least.
From the kick in, let's end up with Bridie on the outer side. It just chips out even wider now.
I wear my hat backwards. It's good.
Warrior's just holding onto the ball. So Mark's taken at centre half back there by Bentley for the Warriors. Now goes out wider towards the bench here at Hogan's Road Reserve. It's a poor kick. It's coming back. Lenardi gets it with the handball, comes back inboard. Spiteri's on, but he's ignored. The kick goes inside 50, looking for Davis. He's unable to take it. It's a low down ball. Picard there with the handball back into the middle. Barbieri, hard at it. Well done, Barbieri. Good clearance. Clears the 50. Kept running to Barbie, but he's ignored because it went to Miles. Another sweeping handball. The Warriors are clear here. The ball comes inside 50, looking for Kitchen. He's unable to take the mark. And the ball comes to Andrews for the Vikings. He clears it to Russo, who handballs over the top to find Turnbull. He goes straight to the middle of Hogan's Road Reserve. Tries to find Davis. He tries to take his opponent on. He's beaten for holding the ball. And the free kick's gone to Arnott at centre-half back, who moves it on quickly now to Turner, who's away. Run down the wing here at the Social Club side of the ground, looking for Kitchen. He's cleared. Clears him, but Kitchen's one of the only player who kept his feet, who gathers. Now Wee's back inboard. Coe's on his right boot inside 50, looking for a target, but he misses them all. And the ball is picked up here by Shields for the Vikings, and he switches across goal.
Vikings, Russo, rewarded left half back. Now he goes out wider still. And now the hand pass over the top. They can work it through the wing now. With a quick bounce, Lunardi, the game's opened up here. Oh, he got heard the voice, Al Hawley just got a touch. Wasn't enough to affect the kick though. Davis took the mark, he's probably within range, just outside the 50. He's got post running back towards goal. The kick wasn't great though. That's across the face.
Tom Z, you think they're too post conscious, the Vikings?
Very much so. I mean, I don't think Jaden Post working hard enough either, just quietly, but you know, he's come up the ground, they ignore that lead, they've left space behind him to kick over and let him run back in, but there's better options, there's another two or three options that they could look for. Altona
kick from Fletcher out wide, spotted up Watt, took the strong mark and then turned it right over, and it's going to come straight back inside to 50. Jar Ward's there underneath it, couldn't take the mark. Now at the back, Rafferty got the hand pass off, and the kick towards goal is just off to the left. Gee, it was nearly a great effort.
Lenardi
really missed Geordie Robbins today since he went off.
Yeah, look, his finishing skills are probably as good as anyone in this competition, Geordie Robbins, and that's where they've fallen down. How many shots Altona have had, you know, just inside the 50, they've just blazed away at goal instead of trying to hit up one of their key forwards. And you know what, the amount of times they miss, they just lose confidence doing that time and time again.
Hoppers Crossing just able to manufacture a way out of their back half with too much ease, and now all of a sudden it's at left half forward. Poland was there, but he saw it out of play. Just no pressure on the kicker coming out of the back half.
No, there wasn't. Too easy. You're right, just far too easy. No pressure at all, just do what they wanted to do there.
Throw in. they go. Bentley was there. The tap goal side, but loitering there were a few defenders from Altona. Now trying to work their way forward. A big kick. And at the back, Bridie, strong hands, took the mark and then played on quickly. Through the middle of the ground now. Turner, couple of bounces and now kicks to centre-half forward, pulled the kick across his body and now working their way on the turnover, Magna Bosco for Altona. Spearing ball towards full forward and Post on the lead, takes the mark. Wastes no time, wheels onto the right boot, kicks to the goal square. Has it got the carry? It slams into the post on the inside as it went through, and that really probably just sums up their day.
He's had nothing going for him today, Posey, has he? I mean, but that's a lot better. A lot better passage of play there from Altona.
120 plays 39.
So Ferrari took the mark from the kick in. Went out wide for Arnott, who now goes back to Ferrari from the kickoff line. Now he goes back. He goes even further forward. Missed Arnott that time. And the ball's going back to Ferrari. And we've got,
I don't know what the umpire's doing.
Over the mark, I think we're going to go.
Why?
I think that was the call. So Watt okay. with the kick. We'll almost send it over. So mark taken to Arnott. As Davis came for the spoil. Chip inside now. Finds Bridie. Kicks it long down the line. Good mark taken out there by
Bentley.
Bentley, yeah. Thanks, Tomsey. Bentley goes along looking for the captain in Ryan. He's beaten by two Vikings players. Now the switch is coming back inboard. The mark's taken there by Turnbull. Goes into the middle of Hogan's Row Reserve and then it's Pickard with the mark. Now kick inside 50 looking for Post. But the ball clears him. Now the ball's at the back for Davis, who beats Al Hall. He now swings back onto the right foot, but I think he's pulled it back too much and he has to the near side. There's one behind there for Davis. Hoppers crossing 18-12, 120. Lead out Tone at 5-11. 40. That's a 79-point lead. 15 minutes gone, final quarter.
The perfect example there was spot on. Going to Post, he had 30 metres in front of him, space, the good strong lead. Okay, get it out to him. He's one-on-one. Had Davis underneath his feet. You know, but the other option, when they just try and make Post run back towards the goals, it just doesn't work. He hasn't got the leg speed to turn around that quickly and get back.
Ball now at left half back for the Warriors. Bridie presents, still running forward from the tip of the defensive goal square. He's now got it just inside the defensive 50. Pokes one short. And now presenting through the middle of the ground is Brent Turner. Again takes the mark and now weaves through the middle on the bike. Good looking kick, but it had a little bit too much on it there for Galley. Followed up though with a good tackle. And it's going to be a free kick though.
Got a player down there.
Yeah, it's going to go against Gelly, I think. There, geez, he picked Gamonzuli. The ball up well, but just ran into the tackle there, Gelly, the young kid.
Gamonzuli.
He's hard at it, that boy.
He is part of the under-19 interleague squad, Gelly. So.
Yes. Keeping an eye on him, Thompson.
I've been told to, yes.
Gamonzuli went short to Magna Bosco. He took the mark in front of Armstrong Weston at centre-half back. Went out wide. Fell at the shoelaces of Cavallaro. Couldn't take the mark. Now he gathers. Hand passes back to Magna Bosco, got the kick out wide.
Corral, you're gone. Well done.
Stepped around his opponent, now got it off to Spatieri, who did well. And now Rafferty. Kick inside the forward 50. Underneath it, Post got the sit and he'll take the mark.
Well done.
Just an easy run at it. And there was no one between him and the footy and he just got a free jump.
So, Thompson, what's his most natural position, do you reckon? Is it one out in the goal square? Because I reckon he's got more to offer.
Yeah.
Or he should have more to offer.
I do agree. He's playing well below his ability of what he should be offering, Kev. I agree. As he does come in and puts that one through.
Yeah, well done.
He, look, I don't know, Kev. I really don't know on that one. I mean, I'd like to see him. He needs space. He can't. He's not a pack mark. He's not. He needs space to be running and hitting the contest. And he's not going to crash packs either. So, you know, get him higher up the ground, maybe. Yeah, I was going to say that half forward, higher up the ground area.
What about at half back, floating? That
yeah, once again, I think he gets knocked off the contest a bit too easy, young Jaden Post. I mean, for a man, and I'll be honest, a man who's played AFL football, his body strength is pretty average. You know, he should be using his body one-on-ones a lot more than what he does. Yeah, saying that kick two today, I mean, he's probably could have kicked two, three or four, to be quite honest. So.
The ball back in the middle. Lenardi with a handball. Gives it to Shields. Handball out wide from Magna Bosco. Gathers. Now kicks it forward and out wide. And it's running onto it. That was Manavong. And the ball now trickles inside 50. Manavong paddles it forward to himself. But Watt meets him. And Watt does well there. Wins the footy. Gives it to Fletcher. Watt kept running. Got it back. Handball's back inside now to Bridie. Little chip ball over the top. Good play here by the Warriors as they clear the defence with a mark taken by Armstrong Weston at left half back.
He's been good today, Murphy Watt Willow.
He has.
A lot of the play,
very hard
a lot
at
of the
it,
football and hard at. Yeah, the body size from what we last seen him 3 years ago has really developed.
So the Warriors now have cleared now with the string of handball. Ends up with Miles now running inside
bang.
50. And as soon as it left his boot, he had the right finger up as he knew it was going straight through the middle. Great goal by the Warriors there, 19. So it's 19-12, 126 to Altona, 6-10, 46. 19 minutes gone, final quarter.
Just starting to show his true worth the last couple of weeks. Reece Miles, as we mentioned, one of the class players of the competition 4 or 5 years ago, decided to nick off and go to another comp for a couple of years and over to the Essendon District last year. Great to see him back where he should be.
11 goals
for us
now.
He was a rookie, one of our rookies of the year, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So, and he was invited down to Werribee a couple of times.
He only just missed the cut.
Yeah.
He would have been in a sub list, but he wanted to go back and play some local footy, but he was right on, I think it was the last one cut.
Yep. He's in the interleague squad too.
He sure is.
Russo, at the back of the pack, cleans up after the tap.
150 blokes are in the interleague squad.
As long as they turn up, Kevin. It doesn't matter how many it's funny, isn't it?
I reckon I got named too.
Yes, everyone, we need a couple of
veterans.
Boys. Veterans, yes.
It's a Wally old veteran.
Won't be water if I'm running it. I can tell you that right now, Tomsy.
Chardonnays for everyone.
Absolutely.
nothing wrong with that.
Goodness
either, quarter
me.
Time.
As that sun creeps back
out. Gilda Bull with a hip flask.
Lenardi kicks to full forward. It's a good-looking kick, but just floating in front. Oh, but roving the pack beautifully was Omar Abu Zidi. Almost had his head taken off. No free kick. And now the pack forms, trying to break out. Brighty, brute strength, gathers and now finds a teammate out wide. It's Matt Smith.
Just back on that post thing. Sorry, guys. Just a perfect example for me then. They try to kick the ball 40 metres to Jaden Post. Instead of getting that one kick closer to him and then giving him that chance to release himself from his opponent. So, you know, coming 45 metres away, that big long kick, it's either going to, if it's not directed perfect to him, it's making it bloody hard for him to get hold of the football. Should be that he should be the second option coming inside that, with a second kick option coming inside that 50.
Chris Ostomo had it, got the kick towards left half back and now on centre wing. Well done by Ben Fletcher, just gets around an opponent and kicks towards half forward. Meade was held onto, surely a free kick, and the whistle is blown. He will get it, the little fella.
He gets most of those.
He does, and he's got 50 metres as well.
Geez.
He enjoyed him. Gotta love him.
Just on that, on the post situation, I don't bat on about too much, but that's the other thing that I've picked up today. I reckon his teammates have put far too much expectation on him to do the miraculous thing in a game like this where they're down.
The difference too, Kev, the hoppers have really spread. They're all looking after each other, especially early piece inside that forward 50 as Geordie Meade comes in from point blank, puts it into the old one tree hill end. And that's his, what's it, third or fourth?
Fourth goal.
Fourth Geordie Meade.
I didn't want to write it down before it was through. Done that enough today.
But you're right, Kev, with back in the post thing without going on, it's just too much expectations of him. And, you know, as I say, every time they get the ball outside the 50, they're going, without even looking, okay, this is where post is going to be, let's kick it long. Find another target, hit up another target 30 metres closer, and then just pull back and let Post give you a lead. Make him work for the ball. I think Jaden Post, I could be wrong, I think he's a little bit lazy sometimes when it comes to getting to the contest. So force him to get up and work hard.
20-12 to 6-10. 22 and a half minutes gone. Back in the middle now. Chris Ostomo was in the ruck for the Warriors, and now it comes out to Poland. Gives a little hand pass over the top, and Miles again. Can he finish? No. The eyes lit up there for Miles.
They did. So there's a bit of a glare from a few of his teammates. A little bit closer, standing there by themselves, actually.
Could have
given that off.
Would have been a really good one. Margin now out to 87.
Got to keep it under 100 here. Altona.
They haven't done a good job from the kicking, so they have a throw in about 40 metres out from the Warriors' goal. Throwing's on its way. It's crumb there by the Warriors. No clear possession yet. Pack forming. Handball out wide by the Vikings. But Ryan Kitchen smothers the ball. And the ball now runs out of bounds just right near the Altona interchange bench.
They'd be very disappointed, the coaching staff. Sadi Gars, after coming off a good win last week, very disappointed in their showing today. They've just had nothing to really say that they're going to be a top five side this year, to be honest.
Picard with the hit out, gives it to Lenardi, who's wrapped up by Barbieri. The ball spills out wide now. Ball now just a hack torpedo forward by the Warriors. Now Davis running onto it. He's got two to beat in Al-Houli and Bridie. But he does well. Davis gets the handball inside 50. The ball's bounced beautifully for Manavon, who kicks to the right, and it just bounces through for a behind. We've lost the scoreboard here, but we've got it at 20-13, 1-33, the 6-11, 47, an 86-point lead to the Warriors as we approach 25 minutes of the final quarter.
What?
Call that. How can you go on? I dare you, Peppy.
What?
Get an accurate ear with that sun in your eyes. I wouldn't have a clue who's who at the moment.
I've got my glasses on. We'll be fine.
All right.
What got the kick in? And now Brent Turner and the outer side. Kick inside 50. And just like that, might have been a little nudge. Ford Mead will get the free kick, yeah. I believe. I think. Or is it going to go the other way?
It's going against him.
Interesting. I don't know how he was possibly holding onto his opponent. Being in front of him, but anyway.
He'll probably get a 50 from this, won't he? Oh, no, it's against me.
Yeah. I don't know what happened there. You're right, he was in front, and the umpire signalled holding on to whoever.
Now the kick almost chopped off. Poland nearly got in the way. Jawad floated across, and now what? Gets on his bike, steps around an opponent, gives a hand pass back to Poland, can go inside 50. Searing pass was beautiful. And Ryan Kitchen, I believe, leading out. Beautifully takes the mark, and he's already got two today, Ryan Kitchen.
I remember too, I suppose this is Altona's only their third game of that boy in round two. A lot of players sort of really struggling and cramping a little bit at the moment for Altona, so match fitness, that's why it's important that they play this one out and run it out hard.
That's a beautiful kick from Ryan Kitchen. Right. Said hello to the left hand goalpost as it sailed through. 21-13, 139 to 6-11-47. We're nearing the 26 minute mark.
Living different
final
goal
term.
Sorry, Pip. Living different goal kickers too for Hoppers Crossing. Obviously Mead with his four, but Kitchen then chipped in with three. Poland with three. Their midfield, their small players obviously really been proactive on the scoreboard again today.
So 92 points the lead here at Hogan's Road Reserve. 26 minutes gone, final quarter. Umpire throws the ball back up in the middle. Big hit by Picard. He's been good today. Probably one of their better plays for the Vikings. It's Ryan who gets the clearance, handballs it to Poland, who chips it forward. It's a bit of a hospital ball, but the mark was almost taken there by Turner. He's now beaten for the ball. The Vikings clear. Goes out wide looking for Magna Bosco. He looks spent. He's hardly jogging after the ball, is he? But he gathers it inside the boundary line. Just handballs over the top looking for Andrews. He does well. Balks the player. Now gives it to Picard. Back to Andrews. Kept on running. Almost runs to his teammate. Now kicks on his left boot. Inside 50 looking for post. 1-2. Almost grabbed at post. Almost a good follow-up. Lenardi at his feet. This wins a hard ball. Handballs it out to post. He gathers. He's slung to the ground. A big tackle by Ferrari, who now comes away with the ball. It's quick to his feet. Then Ferrari, good second effort. Pumps it out, defensive 50, and a good spoil by Russo for the Vikings as the ball trickles out of bounds right on centre wing in front of the Hoppers Crossing Social Club.
Also a bit of cramp going on there too for a few of the Hoppers boys as well.
Jago's lost his boot. He throw in and the siren sounds. Massive win here for Hoppers Crossing. Injuries and a rampant Warriors outfit proved too much for Altona today. 21-13, 139 to 6-11-47. It was just rampant from the Warriors today. They had 11 goal scorers. Geordie Mead led the way with four. Kitchen and Poland with three. Al-Houli, Yago, Bentley had two, and singles to Barbieri, Fletcher, Armstrong, Weston, Watt and Miles.